This is my 4-year-old son. He's basically Van Gogh.
I got a piece for the rainbow, Mommy.
His latest work might not look like much, but it's one of a kind. At least digitally it is. Since you know, I recently minted it as an NFT on the Ethereum blockchain. As one does. Oh, and then I gave it to my mom in an Ethereum wallet.
What is this?
I expect you have no idea what any of that meant. And I didn't either, until I embarked on this project.
Now what the hell's an NFT?
For the NFTs.
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 Yes, NFTs, or non-fungible tokens, are the thing right now. You've got artists selling NFTs of their works, some for millions of dollars. You've got musicians selling NFT songs and audio. You've got brands like Burger King, the NBA, and Macy's making NFTs. I could go on and on, but underlying that vast and wild assortment is the same idea. These are unique, irreplaceable, and verifiable digital things. Okay, but why would you want one? Authenticity. Yeah, Web3, which is after Web2. To impress people. It's a great, though tough question, and we're gonna get there. But first, you need to understand what an NFT is. And the best way to do that? Make or buy one yourself. Okay, so this is my son's art, or what he calls
a masterpiece rainbow unicorn.
You wanna call her NFT?
No.
No?
Boring.
He made it with physical stuff, and then I quickly turned it digital. I scanned it with my iPhone and asked a colleague to animate some of the parts. I ended up with this basic MP4 video file. Sure, I could just upload it to the web or some social media platform, but there, nobody knows that this is the real original thing, that it's not just some digital copy. There's nothing, no digital info that says this is the masterpiece unicorn rainbow NFT made by my son. That's what minting it into an NFT does. Yep, minting, which is the first piece of jargon you need to understand.
Not these mints.
Minting an NFT is the process of taking a piece of content, a JPEG, an MP4, an MP3, some other file, and putting it on a digital registry. In this process, you're recording the stamp of ownership on a blockchain. Jargon term number 2, blockchain. Now, this could be its own video, but here's the simple explanation. The blockchain is a software network where computers run separate copies of the same program. The computers are linked, but no one controls the network. It's called a decentralized network, and it processes transactions. It also keeps a ledger or database with records of every single transaction that happens, every transfer, every purchase, etc. There are many blockchains, including the one for Bitcoin, the crypto you've probably heard all about. Got all that? All right, back to NFT making. I decided to mint the great rainbow unicorn using a service called Chip. But to get started on Chip, I needed to make a crypto wallet. Think of it like a real wallet, but only for the cryptocurrencies and NFTs that you own for a specific blockchain. For this project, I went with the gold standard for NFTs, ETH. It's the cryptocurrency associated with the Ethereum blockchain. MetaMask is one of the most popular ETH wallets. Even though I was making an NFT, I needed Ethereum for various associated fees, which I'll get to. So I bought some on Coinbase, a crypto exchange where you can buy and sell lots of different currencies, and then transferred that to my MetaMask Ethereum wallet. Finally, I was ready. I gave the NFT a title and description, and then uploaded it to Mint. But before it was official, I had to pay what's called a gas fee. For this one, I went straight to Jeff Gluck, the co-founder and CEO of Chip.
On the Ethereum blockchain, gas refers to the cost necessary to conduct a transaction on the Ethereum network. It's a cost associated with powering the network. There are fees associated with other blockchain networks, but typically Ethereum is known to have some of the highest gas fees.
So I paid the gas fee, 0.03333 ETH, or $145.18, and boom.
It's on the blockchain.
I could even confirm it by going to etherscan.io, which has a record of every transaction on the blockchain. Okay, so now I could do a few things with this NFT masterpiece, including sell it. And oh boy, are there a lot of digital art NFTs for sale out there. OpenSea, the biggest NFT marketplace, has millions of pieces. And some of them have crazy high valuations. Look at this cool cat 6133. The highest offer was $26,000 as of making this video. Why so much?
Some of these new NFT projects, such as the cool cats, these are some of the most in-demand, most exciting NFT projects that are out there right now because of the way that they engage a community around their project. They have in real life meetups, events, people connect.
I didn't sell or list the masterpiece unicorn rainbow because I'm not in the art business. But selling is pretty easy once you get to this point. You go to OpenSea, set a minimum price, and see what happens. Just like eBay. Buying an NFT doesn't take as many steps as making or selling one. But most sites, like OpenSea, require you have a crypto wallet. But remember, you're going to pay a gas fee on top of the price of the art, which makes this all very expensive. Instead of selling, I decided to gift my NFT to my mom.
Daughter of the year right here. Her very own MetaMask Ethereum wallet.
Yep, in that envelope, I put her new MetaMask wallet information, which contains her new NFT.
What in the world? This is your crypto wallet, which inside it has an NFT made by your grandson.
Why would I want this?
And that's really the question of the year. Why would you want an NFT? After speaking with lots of people for this story, I came up with a few reasons. One, this is an elaborate, high-tech, energy-sapping way to make money. Because, well, people and companies like money. Then there's the idea of owning digital assets in the metaverse. That is the coming virtual world where we work and shop and hang out. Then there's that cool cats idea. You buy an NFT to gain access to a community. Another popular one is called the Bored Apes Yacht Club, with members like Steph Curry and Jimmy Fallon. And then finally, you love an artist or brand, and you want to own something unique from them. Which I can confidently say is exactly how I feel about my favorite NFT artist.
NFT.
NFTP. NFT.
What does it mean?